and welcome to my video. This is part two of the Valentine's Day breakfast series, and today's recipe is a salty option in case your Valentine doesn't have a sweet tooth. And this is a great recipe for you to make if you have kids because, well, you'll see why. They don't like crust, and the inside of this toast comes out. It's very cute. The whole thing is really adorable. You're going to need a few ingredients, more than a few. And by the way, this is a vegan recipe. Yay! I made a recipe for Sooji toast a while back on my channel, but that wasn't vegan, and this version is. I'm happy to say that it works just as well. The first thing you're going to do is make the batter for this sort of vegan Indian eggs in a basket kind of toast. So just mix all of the ingredients together. I already had my semolina in a bowl, and then I added the tomato, coriander, onion, a little bit of water, and the chickpea flour or besan. And you're going to make a batter that is sort of not too thick, not too thin. I used equal parts of semolina and besan. And you don't really have to worry about this being too lumpy. This generally is not a very lumpy batter. By the way, as a side note, I invented this batter. Actually not, it turns out a lot of people make something similar, but I invented it in quotes for my husband who doesn't eat eggs. And I was telling him one day about how delicious omelets are, and I thought I could come up with something that might be a similar texture as an omelet for him, and he was really satisfied when I made this. It's actually nothing like an omelet, but it is delicious in its own right. And sometimes I just use the batter to make salty kind of squishy crepes. I don't always make this with toast, and that comes out really well too. So now you need to add some spices, and you need to add some turmeric, some mustard seeds, some whole cumin, a little dash of red chili powder, some coriander powder, and combine those into the batter. And of course, somewhere along the line, you have to add salt according to your taste. Hopefully you can get an idea of how thick this batter is, and once this is ready, it's time to heat up your stove and get out your skillet. Brush that skillet with a little bit of oil. Coconut oil is really nice in this, and lay down your toast. And then into that hole where you cut out the flour or the heart, pour some of the batter and spread it out evenly. And brush a little bit of your vegan butter, Earth Balance is really great, or maybe you make your own, along the sides of the toast. And when you can wiggle this, or when you can kind of move it with your spatula, flip it over. And allow this to cook until it has achieved your desired level of crispiness. And, you know, brush a little oil or brush a little bit of that butter as you go. And yeah, that's a little indulgent, but you know, it's a Valentine's Day recipe, so it's okay. And then why I think this is a great recipe if you have kids is because you can whip up a really big batch of these, and like the parents, you can just eat the parts that have the crust, and the kids can eat the inside of the toast if your kids don't like crust. That's actually much tastier, I think, and I'll show you what I mean. So, you know, put down the insides right there and pour the batter just on top of them. And cook these as you would like French toast, and it's going to be a salty French toast. But the insides, I think, actually taste better than the outside. My husband doesn't mind the sort of in a basket version with the crust. I kind of like the insides, but these are so fun, and you can make so many different shapes out of them. That just makes it really enjoyable for the whole family. You can have this as a big Valentine's Day breakfast together. And if you watch my channel regularly, you know that I adore ketchup. I always squirt too much of it, but I love it. So I like this with ketchup, but you could have it with chutney. Coconut chutney would be really delicious. Now, part one in this series was a really delicious and kind of sexy oatmeal. And if you missed that, I will link it for you, but you're in a playlist, so it should play automatically. Thank you for watching and supporting this channel. Please hit the subscribe button and give me a thumbs up. And I will see you next week with another recipe. Mediterranean this time, I think. Okay, bye-bye.